Welcome to today's live session. Can you all hear me? Let me know whether you are hearing me clearly. Waiting for your response. Am I audible? Okay, thank you Shoshagopalan for letting me know that you told me. Good. Okay, so let's begin today's session. So today we will discuss previous papers of games. Okay, so who are all there? Shoshagopalan, Swapnil, Parekh, Kashif. Kashif is there. We have SS Kalaikudam with us. Shalini Gauri Shankar. Good, good, good. Good to see all of you. Okay. So today we will have previous aims question as well as some modified question, because what is the fun of repeating the same question again and again? So I'm going to modify some of the previous aims question so that you will find it something new. Okay. Let's begin with this question. In the crystalline lens, which of the following maintains tocopherol and ascorbate? Tell me the answer. So what is tocopherol? Tocopherol is nothing but vitamin E. What is ascorbate? It's nothing but vitamin C. Okay, Parekh, yeah, that is 25th May. That is actually a plus session. Okay, it's a free special class in the Unacademy platform. So I will have 5 more classes this month on YouTube. Okay. So Tushar, tocopherol is actually vitamin E. Okay. So even on short notice, Parekh, you came. I'm glad that you came. So the question is asking the integrity of tocopherol and ascorbate are maintained by which molecule? So yesterday only we were discussing this in our plus platform. So let me repeat the same thing. Vitamin E is the chain breaking antioxidant. It is the major chain breaking antioxidant. So Parekh, whenever I come to know, I will let you know. Okay. So it's a chain breaking antioxidant. See, look at this. So vitamin E, it functions as an antioxidant. That means it is a reducing agent, right? So in that process, it gets oxidized. So someone has to reduce vitamin E again. So who is coming and reducing vitamin E again? Vitamin C. Again, in that process, vitamin C itself get oxidized. So someone has to come and reduce vitamin C. That is your glutathione peroxidase. The enzyme is glutathione peroxidase, GPX, which contains selenium. Okay, so in that process again glutathione itself get oxidized, so someone has to come and reduce glutathione. So who is going to do that? That is the enzyme glutathione reductase. Hi Devkota, welcome. Are you in Nepal or in India? Glutathione reductase. Okay, is your internship over, Devkota? Clear? Are you clear about this question? Vishwaratna, hello, welcome to the class. Can I move to the next question? If there is any doubt, ask me. Is this clear? Okay. Cool. This question, if consecutive, it's not constitutive, it is consecutive. So sometimes whenever we take questions from question bank, we find that these mistakes are there in question banks. If consecutive sequence of four nucleotides code for an amino acid instead of the usual three nucleotides, how many amino acids can be theoretically formed? So tell me, what is the answer? This is a past question. You should be able to tell. Fadafat, fadafat. So let me explain the basis of this question. See, how many bases are there? Adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine in DNA. In DNA, you have only four bases. Imagine each base codes for one amino acid. So how many amino acids can be coded? So 4 to the power of 1, only 4 amino acids. Imagine two bases will code for one amino acid. So it can be AG, it can be AT, can be AC. So this is the combination, right? So it will be like 4 to the power 2, how many? 16 amino acid. So usually we have the triplet codon, right? So it is 4 to the power 3, 64 amino acids can be coded. But we don't have 64 standard amino acid, right? We have only 21 amino acids, and three codons are stop codons. Out of that three, one codon actually codes for the 21st amino acid. So 23 codons are 23. You are getting the point, right? So 23 are there. What about the rest? So we know that multiple codons code for same amino acids. Multiple codons, they code for same amino acid. This property is known as degeneracy of genetic code. Okay, because we have excess of codons. So that is why multiple codons, they code for one amino acid. This is degeneracy. Clear? So in this question, what was there? Here they are asking, instead of the three triplet, so now they have four. Okay, so if it is four nucleotide, Harshita Dawla, good, good. Parikh, nice. So 4 to the power 4, that is 256. Okay. Degeneracy of the genetic code is due to which phenomena? Wobbling phenomena. Remember, wobbling. Okay. Let's move ahead to the next question. What is the molecular mechanism behind the differential expression of ApoB48 and ApoB100 from the ApoB gene? So from the same gene, we get these products. We get two different proteins in two different tissues. What is the biochemical basis or molecular basis of this? Tell me. What is the basis of this? Good, 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 good. Tushar Mahida, great. Parekh, great. Devkota, good. Dr. Abu, welcome. Good to see you. Swapnil, good. But Dr. Abu, why are you saying it is A? Deshokabalan. Deshokabalan, you forgot. Santanu, Ripurajan, Shalini Gauri Shankar. Okay, Let me explain. Look at this. Look at this. There is same gene, ApoB gene. Okay, from the same ApoB gene, we get two different products in two different tissues. For example, in hepatic tissue, look, there is no editing of the RNA. In the hepatic tissue, the RNA is completely translated. So that is why it is 100% of translation. But in the intestinal tissue, we have an enzyme, cytidine deaminase. Cytidine deaminase. So this converts cytosine to uracil. Look at this. Cytosine is converted into uracil. Okay. So, deamination of cytosine produces uracil. Okay, so what you get? You get a stop codon. So, this happens in the 48%. This happens in the 48%. It's a big protein. It's a very big protein. This happens in the 48% of the ApoB100. So, that is why the product we got is known as ApoB48. Clear? So this is RNA editing. See, look at this. Cytosine is converted into uracil. So don't get confused, guys. What is the answer? Deamination of cytidine to uridine. Okay, cytosine is a base. Cytidine is a nucleoside. Okay. Differential splicing is not the answer. Clear? Whoever marked A, please be careful. This is a past MCQ. Past AIIMS MCQ only I'm discussing. You should never commit mistakes in the previously asked MCQ because all of your friends they will mark it correctly because it's already asked, right? Already asked entrance exam question. Please be careful. So post interns, whether you read new question or not, whether you read textbook or not, you must read and be clear with all the past questions. Okay, clear now, right? Let's move ahead. Simple question. Which of the following is involved in splicing? Which RNA is involved in splicing? So, in this meantime, I will tell you certain key points. You answer. Okay, so Parikh is defending his answer. But see, look, Parikh, it is a known fact. Okay. If it is an unknown fact, you can say that it is differential splicing. But if we know that ApoB48 and ApoB100 are produced by RNA editing, right? So it's a well-known fact. Is it clear? So that's why you should write clearly. So tRNA, it contains maximum number of modified bases. Maximum number of modified bases. Messenger RNA is the, what is the answer? What will you write for messenger RNA? Messenger RNA is the most diverse RNA species. Most diverse RNA. What about ribosomal RNA? It is the most abundant RNA. Okay. So which RNA polymerase is involved? So this is also a question, right? So which RNA polymerase is involved in which one? So look, RNA polymerase 2, RNA polymerase 1, this is RNA polymerase 3. So this has both. So some snRNAs are transcribed by RNA polymerase 3 also. Okay, so the answer is snRNA, which is involved in splicing. So they are uracil rich RNA. They are uracil rich RNAs. So that is why if you see their name, it will begin with U1, U6. So the U stands for uracil, right? So let's take up this question. Which of the following is a suicide enzyme? So here I want you to understand the difference between suicidal inhibitor and suicidal enzyme. These two are different. Suicidal inhibition is something. Suicidal enzyme is something. They are different. Don't get confused. So think and answer. Which of the following is a suicide enzyme they are asking? See, metformins. See, that's why I'm telling you. Suicidal inhibition, if they are asking example, the answer will be different. They are asking suicidal inhibition. Cyclooxygenase will also be the answer. Xanthine oxidase will also be the answer. Okay, that is for suicidal inhibition. So these enzymes, they undergo suicidal inhibition. But suicidal enzyme is different. So suicidal enzyme is cyclooxygenase. The enzyme itself is regulated by self-catalyzed destruction. Okay, self-catalyzed destruction. This is a remarkable feature of cyclooxygenase. So this line you will find in Harper. So in the Harper, they have clearly mentioned cyclooxygenase is a suicidal enzyme. Okay, clear? So never ever commit. Again, this is a past question. Whoever is committing mistake in the past question, please don't do it. Sunny Yadav, welcome to the class. But see, this we have discussed in our plus course. Sunny Yadav, please don't do this mistake again, especially in the exam. Okay, suicide enzyme and suicide inhibition, they are different. So multiple times I have told you, but still many people are making mistakes. So don't worry, I will tell again and again. So certain things need to be repeated again and again so that people will fix this in their mind. Let's move ahead to the next question. Which of the following is the starting material for production of insulin from bacteria? So what they are asking, how are you going to produce protein? What are you going to produce? Eukaryotic protein in the prokaryote. So they are asking about cloning, right? So expression of protein, expression vector. So eukaryotic protein in the prokaryotic. How are we going to do this? What is the first material needed for that? Tell me, guys. Is the first material needed for that? Again, this is a past question. All questions are previous year questions only, nothing is new. Let's see who is answering correctly. Parekh, Vaibha Panchal, Tushar Mahida, Dr. Abu, Swapnil, Deepu Rajan, Parak Sharma, Prabha Venkat, Arshita, Adi Sankaran, Monika, Keshagopalan. Okay, I think most of you are answered. Who are left? Ravi Roshan, Pratya Prati. Who else is going to try again? Okay, it seems most of you answered. Now let me explain. The answer is not C. Okay. Answer is not C. Parekh, you cannot say something like that, right? Insulin made from messenger RNA, not from DNA. See, from the DNA only we synthesize what? Let me take this. From the DNA only insulin is made. DNA. Messenger RNA. So in vivo it is DNA, mRNA, then protein. So that is normally how it is made. That is correct only. Okay, so yeah, insulin is made from messenger RNA, but messenger RNA, that comes from DNA. So this is inside our human body, inside human body. But now you have to clone this. Okay, if you just put the DNA, you take the insulin gene, you put this insulin gene in the bacterial plasmid. First of all, tell me, do bacteria have splicing mechanism? Do bacteria have splicing mechanism? No, not at all. You know, right? In the bacteria, you don't have introns. So obviously, you cannot put insulin DNA. Bacteria do not have splicing. Okay. So you put this, there is no splicing. So you cannot synthesize. Just by putting the DNA, you cannot synthesize insulin. That is why, if you see some ordinary books and all, they give something like this. See, they are depicting the insulin gene someone is putting. So I just did a web search and I found everything is wrong. Okay, so they're like, see, put insulin gene, you add insulin gene in the plasmid, the transgenic bacteria, and extract insulin. See, what is this? You cannot do this. This is wrong. You cannot put insulin gene DNA as such. Okay, so you here the insulin genes should be in the form of cDNA, not in the form of genomic DNA. So genomic DNA, we use the word gDNA. cDNA is the complementary DNA. Okay, so this, thank God they have not mentioned it is genomic DNA. So look at this. I then looked into a standard textbook. So we should always refer to standard textbook. In the standard textbook, they have clearly mentioned. So mRNA, messenger RNA for insulin production. Okay, so that is extracted from beta cell of pancreas. Then we purify. Okay, we just want only the messenger RNA for insulin. So we can do that by certain mechanisms. So we just take messenger RNA for insulin. Then we use a specific primer. We just use a specific primer which will go and bind to the messenger RNA for insulin only. Okay, so here we don't use this oligo DT primers and all. So DNA synthesis, for cDNA synthesis, people use oligo DT and random hexamers. You must be aware of these term, right? Random hexamers. We are not going to use this because we just want to convert only the insulin messenger RNA into cDNA. So we can use gene specific primer. Okay, gene specific primer. After that, there is a lengthy story. So for exam purpose, this much is enough. Now you are convinced, right? Why the answer is D. Okay, remember this. This has been asked in AIIMS entrance exam. Clear? So please, please, if it comes in exam, you should mark this only, option D. Right. Now, very simple question. Which of the following enzymes catalyze the irreversible steps of glycolysis? I always tell people that irreversible step of glycolysis is catalyzed by kinases. Okay, so you can remember like this. Kinases, they catalyze the irreversible steps of glycolysis. But if you see in the option, all kinases are given. Okay, so how to do? So just by knowing this trick, you won't be able to answer this. So you should know exactly what are all those three enzymes. Good. Parekh, Abbu, Swapnil, Shesha, Ravi, Nikhil Mishra. Good, good, good. You're all doing good. Arkaprava, Parag, sorry, Parag Sharma, Sadia Khan, Prabha, good. Monica, good. So, out of the four kinases in the glycolysis, there is criminal list topper. So we have a criminal list topper also with today. So we don't know what are all the crimes he have committed. I think the crimes he have committed is attempting AIIMS, JIPMER, PGI exams. So out of these kinases, there is one kinase which is reversible. Look at this. Phosphoglycerate kinase is reversible kinase. Ulali Ramu, welcome. So look at this. Phosphoglycerate kinase is common to both glycolysis as well as gluconeogenesis. Okay. It is a reversible kinase. So most of the times you may think that all kinases are irreversible. No. Phosphoglycerate kinase is reversible. So phosphoglycerate kinase is here. So that is gone. So here it is gone. So you can obviously exclude D, C, B. So the answer is A. Okay, so excellent. Many of you have answered nicely. Good. So now I have seen some questions, the past questions, and I modified them into assertion and reason question. Okay, so that it will be something like a new question. These are the past questions only. I just modified them. Look at this assertion reason. Glucose 6 phosphatase deficiency leads to severe hypoglycemia. Glucose 6 phosphatase is involved in glycolysis as well as gluconeogenesis. Answer this one, as well as gluconeogenesis. Out of these five options, you select which is the correct option. So glucose 6 phosphatase deficiency, what is the name of the disease? Is Von Gierke. What? Von Gierke's disease. So now we have people having difference of opinion. See, someone is saying C, B, D. People are having confusion in mainly C, D, B. B is also coming. Let's see which is more coming. So this one is correct, right? In Von Gierke's disease, you have severe hypoglycemia, especially fasting hypoglycemia. Okay. So assertion is correct. You don't have any doubt in this, right? Assertion is correct. But look at the reason. Glucose 6 phosphatase is involved in glycolysis as well as gluconeogenesis. See guys, you might have read it wrongly. See, look at this. It is glycogenolysis. Okay. So in the hurry, you might have thought that okay, this is wrong, correct only. It's glycogenolysis. So if it is glycogenolysis, then option one is correct. But look at this. Assertion is an independently true statement, but reason is a false statement. Rachitsa, good. Shesha, good. Parik, nice. Dilip, so you all answered correctly. Clear? Glucose 6 phosphatase is involved in glycogenolysis. Okay. So if you see, in the endoplasmic reticulum, you have glucose 6 phosphatase. So after glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis, glucose 6 phosphate has to come here. Okay. Now look at this question. Acetyl CoA is not glucogenic. Acetyl CoA stimulates pyruvate carboxylase. What could be the answer? Pyruvate produces acetyl CoA. You all know the reaction is pyruvate dehydrogenase. So there is oxidative decarboxylation happening here. What is the oxidation happening here? NADH is released. That is the oxidation. Decarboxylation is release of CO2. Tell me guys, which could be the answer? Abbu, Parekh, Parag Sharma, Tushar, Shesha, Mad for Ames, Swapnil alone, Ravi. Shesha changed your answer. So from 4, Shesha changed his answer to 2. Okay. हर्षिता, रचित शाह, प्रतिया, स्वप्निल, प्रभा वेंकट, मोनिका, गुड गुड. सो लेट्स एनालाइज. असिटाइल को ए कैन नेवर बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज. दिस क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्ड एट लीस्ट 5 times इन एम्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द फेवरेट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दम. असिटाइल को ए कैन नॉट बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज. व्हाई? असिटाइल को ए इज कंप्लीटली ऑक्सीडाइज्ड इन द टीसीए साइकिल. Moreover, the conversion of pyruvate to acetyl CoA is an irreversible reaction. You cannot reverse the reaction. Clear? So, option A is, sorry, assertion is correct. So, it's a correct statement. Good, Parik. Acetyl CoA stimulates pyruvate carboxylase. So, I told you, right? So, pyruvate is converted into acetyl CoA. This acetyl CoA inhibits its own conversion. But it will activate the conversion of pyruvate to oxaloacetate. Okay, so this is also a true statement. Reason is also a true statement, but the reason cannot explain the assertion. So these A and R are independently true statement. Okay, so where is that option is there? So that option is in the B. Okay, so both statements are independently true, but R is not the explanation for assertion. Clear? So I guess you got this point. Acetyl-CoA stimulates pyruvate carboxylase, but that is not the reason for assertion. Good guys, you are all answering nicely. Even though you have difference of opinion, it's fine. So we are here to learn together. Look at this question. Look, glucose 6 phosphatase in the cytoplasm of hepatocyte is not acted upon by glucose 6 phosphatase as soon as it is formed. The reason they assume is glucose 6 phosphatase is in the mitochondria. So try to answer. What could be the answer here? So hepatocyte is the major site for gluconeogenesis as well as glycogenolysis. It is the liver, right? Liver contains glucose 6 phosphatase, but muscle tissue does not contain glucose 6 phosphatase. So that is why muscle glycogenolysis cannot increase the blood glucose. So look at the reason. Glucose 6 phosphatase is in the mitochondria. That is wrong. Just now I told you glucose 6 phosphatase in the what? It is in the endoplasmic reticulum. So R is a false statement. But assertion, if you see, assertion is an independently true statement. Okay. So glucose 6 phosphatase in the cytoplasm is not acted upon by immediately because it is produced in the cytosol, but it has to go to endoplasmic reticulum. So Parag Sharma, Pratya, Prabha, so you all answered correctly. Nice, nice guys. I'm so proud of you. So finally, we have two questions which are of matching type. Again, these questions are all asked previously. So I took all the previous questions and I put them in the matching format. So now you will have fun, right? Try to match these columns. Good, good, good. Try to match this. Cyber green. So we pronounce this as cyber green. S-Y-B-R green, we pronounce cyber green. Horse radish peroxidase. So whenever we mean peroxidase, it is going to act on hydrogen peroxide. Okay, that is H2O2. Sodium dodecyl sulfate. Dodecyl sulfate is what? SDS. Agarose beads. So agarose beads are like beads with particular size. Say some agarose beads, they can have pores. Some agarose beads can be like charged, so they may contain carboxymethyl cellulose, positively charged or negatively charged beads. So these are the various agarose beads. So take your time, don't worry, answer slowly. I know it will be difficult. Answer slowly. So let's go one by one. Cybergreen is a dye which binds only to double stranded DNA. So during PCR, real time polymerase chain reaction, we add cybergreen. So only when there is a significant amount of amplification, the threshold for this cybergreen fluorescence will be reached and you will get a signal. So the intensity of the signal is directly proportional to the initial amount of messenger RNA we are trying to quantify. So cybergreen is used in real time PCR. So 1D. So if it is 1 is D, these two are gone obviously. This is the advantage of match the following question. What about harsh radish peroxidase, HRP? So HRP is an enzyme. So this enzyme is used in ELISA, any chromogenic technique. So out of these, chromogenic technique is ELISA only. So color producing technique, right? So in ELISA, we produce color. So 2 is A. So obviously, see, 2 is E, so it's gone. So this is the advantage of match the following type. If you know the two options correctly, 100% sure, you can be right. If you know three also 100% sure, you can answer correctly. So that is the whole advantage of match the following. So that's why I like match the following questions much. So sodium dodecyl sulfate, SDS. So SDS page is actually a step in Western blot. Okay, so in Western blot, first we do STH page only. After electrophoresis only, then we transfer the protein in the nitrocellular membrane, RPVDF membrane, any membrane. Those days they used nylon membrane also, right? So we can also transfer in nylon membrane. In our lab, we use either nitrocellulose or PVDF membrane. So for southern blotting, I think people use nylon membrane. For proteins, we prefer these membranes. Then after that, you do blocking, then you add primary antibody, then the secondary antibody. In between, you have to wash all these. Okay. Then you add whether you want to detect fluorescent method or chromogenic method. So guys, actually, harsh radish peroxidase can also be used in Western blot. So 2B is also correct, but here we have to select the best option, right? See, but 1A is not at all the correct answer. So that is why, even though 2B is correct, because of the other option, okay, agarose beads cannot be used in karyotyping. Abbu is saying, sir, but in AIIMS, separate options will be there, and we have to drag and place answer. Is it so, Abbu? Oh, I was not aware of that. But still, again, see, if you drag also, now if you exclude one thing, right, one distractor, getting my point? So if, okay, but still, it's always good to learn better. So sodium dodecyl sulfate, it can be for Western blot, it can also be for, sorry, it's for Western blot. Harsh radish peroxidase can be for ELISA, it can also be for Western blot. Okay. So based on the question, you use your presence of mind and answer correctly. Sodium dodecyl sulfate, you know, right? Western blot only. Agarose beads, as I told you, agarose bead, it will go for what? Chromatography. So in the agarose beads, there will be particular size. Then it will be a size exclusion chromatography. If there is a charged molecule, that will be ion exchange chromatography. So we use agarose beads. So here they are using that agarose beads. Okay. It is not agarose. They are saying agarose beads. That is why it is chromatography. If they just say agarose, agarose is used in what? Agarose, just agarose. Agarose is used in electrophoresis also. In Western blood also, what we use? We use polyacrylamide. Clear? So karyotyping is just to distract you. Karyotyping is just to distract you guys. Okay. So the answer should be, let me write the answer. One, I think I gave the answer wrongly. So cyber green, 1D. Horseradish peroxidase, 2A, 3B. So I think none of these, it seems. 4 agarose beads, 4E. Okay, so everyone is getting 100% mark in this question. So you all got correct. Okay, sometimes this happens. So don't worry, whenever there is wrong in the key, you get 100%. But the thing is, whoever answered that question, they only get it. Okay, so you have to take a gamble. Whenever you find that, okay, this question could be wrong, if it is absolutely wrong, then you go for it. Okay, only those who students who answered that, they will get it, get the mark. Okay, those who skip the question, they won't give that mark. This is a gamble only. You have to select. Clear? So final question of today. This is the final question. I hope I here also I give the correct answer. Let's see. Dideoxynucleotide, polyamphiolates, DNA probe conjugated antibody. So here we have ELISA, real-time PCR. See, again I gave real-time PCR. Again I gave ELISA, FISH, isoelectric focusing, Sanger sequence. So this is my last question for today. Try to answer this. So dideoxynucleotide do not contain 3 prime OH group as well as 5 prime OH group. So that means if dideoxynucleotides are incorporated, they will cause chain termination. So dideoxynucleotide chain termination method. So which one is this? It should be chain termination method is Sanger sequencing. So 1E for sure. So 1A, this is gone. This is gone. See, now two are gone. But you told, right? Who told? Abbu told, na? So we have to remove. So we cannot use that one. So you have to know all the four options. As Abbu is telling, so it will go like this. Sanger sequencing. Polyamphiolates are used to create a pH gradient in the isoelectric focusing. So 2 should be D. Okay, so it should be 2D. Prabha Venkat, Arumai Arumai. DNA probe is used in what? FISH. So in FISH, we know we use DNA probe. So conjugated antibody, obviously now you all know this is an immunoassay, right? So out of this, which is the immunoassay? Only ELISA is the immunoassay. Immunoassay means using specific antigen body and antigen antibody interaction. So that is immunoassay. So antibody is there. So none of the other technique is immunological technique. See, look at this. So these are not immunological technique. So obviously immunological technique, this one. So the answer is A. This is your answer. So this is our final question of the day. And these are the routine classes happening in the Unacademy. Please try to participate and get most of the out of the them. And people asked, what is my next class? In the Unacademy platform, my next class will be on 25th May 2020. This is in the Unacademy platform. So in the Unacademy platform, I have this 1 hour and I have 1 more hour class also. So 1 hour in Unacademy and 5 classes, 5 free classes are left. So in this month, five classes are yet to come, don't worry. So five classes in YouTube. And these are my plus courses. So this is for members who have taken the plus membership. I think many people, they gave just 1 rupee and they got 1 month of free membership. So there are many lucky people, and many people, they have taken plus courses also. So I am completing the molecular biology here. All of you, please join our Telegram group so that you will know. So that's what, Parik, join the Telegram group. In the Telegram group, I will try, because whenever I get the link only, I can put it, right? So that is the thing. So I get the link, then immediately I put. So today I got the link, immediately I put. So that is the thing. So it is the link, getting the link. So join our Telegram group, Biochemistry with Karthi. And if you want to take plus subscription, if you have any doubt, feel free to contact me, okay? Whenever you are in a doubt, dilemma, what are the advantages of plus, I will tell you. So you can contact me in the Telegram. So join our Telegram group, t.me Dr. Karthi, okay? Or else you can also just search this one, okay? More questions are molecular biology, okay? Your suggestion is taken. We will put more questions, Ravi, don't worry. So Prabha Venkat, thank you very much. Nandri, nandri. So with this, we complete today's class. All of you, enjoy, enjoy. Next YouTube, I don't know, I have to ask them. That is the thing. So they give the schedule, so I follow it. So I'll tell you, don't worry. I enjoyed with you guys. Thank you very much for joining. See you in the next class. Bye bye.